Hey guys, Steve here, SAMTB. So I'm here in Florida. I'm at Santos Trails. We are in Central Florida, just south of Ocala. And I stopped in at the Santos Bike Shop a little bit earlier and picked up this Santa Cruz Tallboy to demo out here. I got out here really super early because it's really hot. Surprise, Florida's hot, I know. I wanted to get out on this bike. I really wanted to get out on the 5010 too. We may do that, but anyway, so today we're talking about the Santa Cruz Tallboy and just what a phenomenal bike. Kind of just give you a quick heads up on this bike here, give you kind of an overview. So this is the Tallboy C. So it's carbon fiber frame, carbon triangle. We have the NX build, which means our NX shifter on the rear, derailleur. I was corrected, it's not a derailleur, it's a derailleur. And then the guide T brakes. So super familiar for me because this is the same like transmission setup and braking system as I have on my bike, the Ibis Ripmo AF. Same exact setup. On the front, we got the Minion DHFs. And the EXO casing, which is interesting, not the EXO Plus. And then we have the DHRs 2s on the rear. Great tires, a little narrower than what I've been riding on. Just gonna throw that out there. I did notice a difference riding on this bike. So this has something called a VPP, a virtual pivot point. And that means that where you feel you are on the bike isn't exactly how it's engineered. It's made so that you feel like you're sitting lower on this bike, and it makes it a way more playful bike. It has 120 mil of travel on this Fox float on the rear here, and 130 travel on the Pikes up front. Great bike overall, super playful, lots of fun. Some things I did notice though was, even with the lightness of this bike, the shortness of travel, I noticed it pretty significantly. Probably because I've been riding on a much longer travel bike in the last couple months, and on kind of like bigger trails with a lot more descent. This is a lot flatter and very techie trails. I was on something called Snake Pit or something back there, and it was a great trail, lots of fun, lots of little techie features, but the bike was light, so you can kind of throw it around. But rolling over the roots and stuff in this combination of like sand and roots, I actually was out on my Ripmo, which is about 5 or 6 pounds heavier than this bike, and felt like that rolled a little bit better. So nothing against this bike. Great bike. If you're looking for something like this, that kind of a mid short travel, I definitely would recommend this bike to anybody. Very, very capable bike. But if you're looking for something a little bit bigger, if you're maybe on Western US or like Western North Carolina even, you're probably gonna want something with a bit more travel than this. If you like to kind of like stay on the greens and the blues and kind of more of a rolly, you know, flow track, this might be just perfect for you. Just kind of throwing it out there. These run around 44,000 to 5,000, depending on how you set them up. This one runs around 4, I believe. I will leave a link in the description below for this bike and also for Santos Bike Shops, the guys that I rented this from. They were awesome today. Great bike shop right up here in Central Florida, just south of Ocala. So there you go, guys. I'll leave all the other techie stuff and all that. You know, you can geek out on all the other, like, you know, geometry and head angles and all that stuff like that. Just the bike ride's great. Like I said, nice, light, fun bike. If you're looking for a light, fun bike, this is your bike right here. Great bike, awesome, rides great, love it, have fun on it. Thanks so much, guys. I'm gonna hit the trails, hit some more footage for you guys, kind of see how it handles a little bit like that, probably about another hour here, and that's it. Thanks so much for stopping in here. Take a look at some of this footage. See you guys soon. Got a little rock feature here. I'm kicking my butt all day. So let's get this one little bump here. I bump up, come up here, hop up this rock here. Try to clear that. Lots of pedal strikes there. come on up, and then you get to this part and you're pretty clear. Not bad. So we're gonna give that a shot right now. See how we do. Let's see how this looks. Well, here we go, guys. Final thoughts. Santa Cruz really hit this one out of the park with the Tallboy. It's really a great bike. It is super capable. Really, the only thing about this bike that holds it back from being your one and only bike you could need for pretty much anything is the fact that it's only got 130 mil of travel up front and 120 in the rear. But to be honest, I think most riders would be more than comfortable on this bike for most every trail that they ride. I mean, we see guys bombing down mountains on these massive travels, and the fact is most of us don't do that. I mean, if you do, great, but this bike should not be disqualified simply because it doesn't have 160, 170 mil of travel. It's a super capable bike. It's light, it's fun, it's a blast, it's capable. Really can't see any reason that you shouldn't check it out if you're in the market for a new bike and you are looking for something in this range. Definitely check out the Tallboy. Santa Cruz has really got some great bikes out and some new stuff coming out soon too, so definitely take a minute and check those guys out. Well, thanks so much for watching, guys. Don't forget to click that subscribe button and the like button. And if you have any questions about this bike, please leave them in the comment section below. I'm happy to help you guys out any way I possibly can. Hey, also, we're going to be doing a couple more videos from Florida. A Florida series coming up in the next couple weeks, so look forward to sharing those with you. Also, finally, love to come out and ride on some of your trails. If you've got some trails you think are the best around, give me a shout, and I'd love to hook up with you and get a ride in with you on your trails. All right, guys, talk to you soon.